Thank you. I can just send from comment line. I can just send it to the second.
Yeah.
I'm in
comment call from my lab, chairman.
I'm comment lab, Motibura, Commissar Lidlick.
I'm comment interpretation for the chairman.
I'm not going to be chairman. Crossword of bombs, Vanical chairman.
I'm Comrade Joseph Mokwena, Secretary for Tradition and Religion at National Level.
Our Secretary for Administration, Comrade Mashaya Mombe, our National Chairperson, Comrade Eunice Sandimoya, and we've brought with us the attendance register for the meeting that resolved. That passed the resolutions that we want to read to you. I don't know if I could start. The National Patriotic Front founding National Executive Committee, in line with the transitional provisions of our Constitution, yesterday met and deliberated on the strategic issues that need to be addressed in line with our election rollout plan, and resolved that A, the party, as provided for in section 33.1C of the party constitution, engage other political parties and explore and or join any coalition as may be deemed strategic in advancing the interests of the party in the critical 2018 general election. This is a provision in the party constitution. So the meeting met and endorsed that provision. The meeting also endorsed that the work done so far by a team led by the national chairperson in ongoing negotiations for the purposes of forming an electoral pact with the coalition partner be completed before Monday, 11 June 2018. We also resolved that the party's inaugural convention be held after the July 30 harmonized elections. The meeting also noted that Comrade Mutinhiri, our interim president, who on the 9th of May 2018 at an NFEC meeting in Bordeaux apologized for his nonchalant approach to the task the party assigned to him, still showed gross incompetence, lack of commitment to the party and its cause, and therefore the meeting decided to relieve him of his current duties pending reassignment. The interim president, therefore, as a resolution, the interim president, retired Brigadier General Ambrose Mutinhiri, is therefore recalled from his current position after he teamed up with a former cabinet minister to hire thugs to disrupt an NFEC meeting at Magolis Resort in Harare yesterday. The NFEC also noted that Comrade Mutinhiri's alliance with the former cabinet minister points to a deliberate ploy to disrupt the NPF activities, especially the ongoing coalition talks. The decision to recall Comrade Mutinhiri was unanimously endorsed by all the NFEC members present at the meeting, and we have brought the register. You can take copies of the signatures of the people who attended the meeting and their phone numbers. Honorable Chair.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as you have just been listening to narration by Comrade Mawarire, I would like you to know that it has not been easy for us to run this party. It's a new party in the form that new parties are formed. But in reality, we are the background of G40. I think you should know that. And G40 was falling, was coming down from the higher structures of the party, ZANU-PF, down to the branches and the cells. Why? Because of a negative attitude that was taken by some of our comrades against the young generation. We felt as G40, they called us, it was time that younger people take over the running of the government of Zimbabwe. And that was not accepted by the present junta setup, who felt that they themselves liberated themselves, not the nation of Zimbabwe. I want to remind all of you that when we went to the war, the idea was brought up by young people who got together and decided that they will go there where the elders were and take arms to fight the liberation struggle. Those people were not as old as we are now. They were young people like you. Therefore, it was time for us now to say, let the young ones come and take over. But we were never given that chance. We saw some tanks all over the country attacking us without any reason, calling us thugs, calling us thieves. But up to now, no one has been arrested. Yes, we appreciate what Comrade Mutinhiri did by resigning from parliament and pledging to work with the people of Zimbabwe in doing away with the junta. But since then, that was the only good statement that he ever made. And it ended there. He didn't want to work with us, whom he said were G40s. He wanted to create his own structures. We said, fine, let him go as long as we have the same agenda, that of addressing the anomaly, the subnormal situation that was there. He moved on. There were no results from his side. When he realized that we had started programs running around the country, he decided to come back. He approached me as the national chairman. He never condemned me that why am I acting when there's no president. He came and said, I apologize, just as you have heard from the report. I would like to attend your meeting. And I said, no, I will not let you go in there because people are going to be hostile with you. But I will call my top 10, who will talk to you. You tell them what you have told me. And of course, he did that. He told them that, look, I apologize. I didn't work with you from the beginning. I think now I'm ready. And please, can you forgive me? And that my 10 members of the National Executive accepted his apology. However, since then he has not been active. We tried by all means, we send him a WhatsApp, want to have a meeting, want to have this. He doesn't respond. We don't know whether he came to us because we're beginning to show who we are, and maybe working with some other people who are trying to destabilize or push us to a wait so that we don't carry on waiting for his authority. But he never called a meeting, not even one day. He never phoned me. I have the right to call meetings as the chairman of the party, but he's never called me for any meeting. We only saw Comrade Mutinhiri yesterday when he came with a gang of thugs. They were traveling in two combis. I think you know the name of that group. They used to be called Chipangano, and they were hired. We have got proof that they were hired. We can discuss the rest about it any other day, any other time. We'll leave it for another day. However, they tried their best to disrupt the meeting until I had to close the meeting. And then we decided to reassemble. I told my chairperson, we have got six chairpersons who come from six provinces who support us because they are the ones who endorsed us without engineering. they are the ones who endorsed us as the founding national executive. And according to the constitution, we are the only body that can talk about this party besides Mutinhiri and even outside him. So we feel so disappointed that we have to recall Comrade Mutinhiri, because there's no platform where we can speak to him and show him how wrong he was. If he is going to travel with thugs who were manhandling some of us, it's very difficult to call him to a table and say, let's talk. It's very difficult. Because some of us have sympathies towards Comrade Mutinhiri. He's a Zebra former combatant and a commander, for that matter, he was. And I was there with him. And that's one reason why I sympathized with him and took him to my colleagues that we can accept him. We never, never endorsed Mutinhiri ourselves, but we allowed him to work with us. So I think I've said a mouthful. Unless if you want some more, I'll wait for questions.
Do we have any questions?
Come on, Chief.
Thank you.
Comrade Chairperson, would you want to probably explain, is this a split? You say you have six chairpersons who endorsed your executive. Is this a split? Are they four, the other four chairpersons, are they supporting Comrade
Chairperson? Actually, there are seven chairpersons, but the other three had already left after the disruption of the meeting yesterday. So when we reconvened, they'd already left. The chairperson information had already left when we reconvened.
So you're saying only seven were still at the meeting that endorsed this decision to
the seven managed to attend. The seven managed to attend.
You said you're thinking of joining an alliance.
Yes.
Have you thought of any, which one is it?
In fact, we are not thinking of joining an alliance.
We have
started
talks.
We are at a very advanced stage in those talks. That's the reason why you see with the National Founding Executive Committee saying that the talks should be complete by Monday. These are talks that that were already in motion. And that's the reason why we find the involvement of the former cabinet minister that we spoke about. We believe that he was doing that in lieu of his freedom. We suspect he came back here to disrupt our project. And he was incensed when we went and gave solidarity to the MDC Alliance March. That started everything. And when the thugs came, they had a list of people that they wanted to attack. Primarily the spokesperson, they said, I had the documents for the alliance. And they also wanted to attack the National Political Commissar, Comrade Diabunu, and our Secretary General, Comrade Mashana. They thought we were the guys behind the alliance formation. And it's also, I think it also explains what was the motivation, because the three of us were the prominent people who joined the MDC alliance.
So you're not at liberty to tell us what is alliance?
I think we will make a joint press statement, and I think it's only fair that we wait for that, and it will be very soon. I think early next week, maybe Monday next week, or even Saturday.
Yes.
Okay, thanks. I think if I heard well, you said that Brigadier Chini came with the former cabinet minister.
No, okay. We said he came with thugs.
Thugs, okay.
That he had hired. He was coming from a meeting with the former cabinet minister. In fact, there was a meeting in March Central on Wednesday.
Okay, I had liberty to name the
I think I've said quite a lot. Now you know the name.
And my second question is, joining an alliance now,
yes.
While you see the state, probably more constituencies.
No, we have completed that exercise, Comrade. We have completed that exercise with our alliance partner. That one is sorted out. In fact, the thing that we are left with is not even sharing of the constituencies. That has been done. and we have agreed on the constituencies. We are going to announce the number of constituencies that we are going to contest in and the number that we have given to them. So that one is not an issue. We have we have agreed on that one.
Yes.
In the interim, the national chairperson, like she was doing, is acting. Continues to act as she was doing.
You are on record saying you do not recognize the administration of the current president.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. And my question is, why are you going to the election that he is called when he himself is not elected, according to your
to mobilize people so that they vote against him, and any election that you suspect people might compromise. The easiest thing that you can do is to mobilize so that the voter turnout gets beyond 75%. Once you do that, it's difficult to rig that election. So that's the motivation. We want him out, and if we have tried all other things, and the only thing that is left is to mobilize our people to vote in numbers. And that's why we are getting into a coalition. We are combining our strength with the strength of the MDC. If and other parties, if MDC showed the strength that they showed in Harare, we can also demonstrate that kind of support in like we did in Kwekwe. If we combine those numbers, he's gone.
So let me get this straight. As NPF, we are not in this election to win, but to disrupt.
No. To win, comrade, we have parliamentary seats that we are contesting to win, not to disrupt. How do you disrupt? we are contesting to win. He's contesting his seat to win. I'm contesting my seat to win.
But we are joining forces.
Yes, but we are joining forces. And when you join forces, you don't disrupt, comrade. You strengthen each other.
Comrade, thank you. Comrade Chairperson, again, to this question is to you. You indicated that when you asked Comrade Mutinhiri to take interim charge of the party, you did that because he had resigned his seat in Parliament to work with the people. What was the role played by former President Mugabe in that challenge?
I don't think I have something that I can say about that. I will allow the one who speaks through us to say something.
President Mugabe, his role has been very clear. He said, if you do ABC, and we've said that on record, that he said, if you fight for the return to constitutionalism, if you fight for democracy, I will support a political party that is formed on those bases. If you fight for the empowerment of the black people, he will support us. And that's the role that he played. No, that's the promise that he gave us. If that promise is a role, if it makes you believe it's a role, then maybe that's the role that he played, was promising us his support, and we really treasure that support.
Is he aware now that you're going into bed with the motto NPF?
We are not going into bed. We are going into an alliance.
Okay. Is he aware you are going into an alliance?
Yes, he is aware.
He is aware.
Yes.
So you've been briefing him.
I didn't say that. I say yes, he is aware.
We said at the beginning that we are at liberty to go and consult him on any issue that we feel we want to consult him. And we've consulted him on the issue of the alliance.
And he's happy with it.
Yeah.
Has he given his direct support to the candidature of Advocate Nelson?
We said he is happy with the alliance talks. I don't know where we are getting Nelson from. So we said we are talking to a partner. We never said we are talking.
Yeah, I asked you the question.
We gave solidarity to Chamisa, but we are talking to a partner.
Chamisa, you are going into this election confident that you are going to win.
Yeah.
And obviously, membership plays a key role.
Yes.
Are you privy to tell us how many party card carrying members do you have as NPF nationally?
Comrade, if you are mobilizing for an election, you don't sell party cards. you don't take money from people when you're mobilizing
members.
For an election.
Right.
You mobilize people
members
that are going to vote for you. Mm-hmm. ZANU PF has less than 800,000 card carrying members.
Mm-hmm.
But the people who have been voting President Mugabe are above 2 million. So it's not everything. You don't, when you are going into election, in election, you don't target members. You target people that are going to support you, that are going to vote you on election day. Yes. So that includes your members, that includes your sympathizers, that includes people that you twist on election day to vote for you, persuade them even on voting day. Yes.
To come back.
You said Comrade Mutinhiri never called for a meeting or after his being endorsed as the party leader. How did you interpret that as a party, that kind of behavior, as well as the attack?
We thought it was incompetence. We thought it was nonchalance. That's why we gave him a chance to come back. When he come back and apologize, we thought we can take him. We were prepared to work with him. We were prepared to push him, because we thought when he resigned, he was committed to our cause. So yeah, we gave him a chance. But when he came with hired thugs and when it was completely evident that he was here, yeah, that he was working with that former cabinet minister, we said no, we can't take this anymore. Because we knew why the cabinet minister was there. Remember, we've always been saying these guys are not members of NPF, because we knew what was going on. We knew the negotiations that were going on. We knew the meetings in Zambia with General Chiwenga. We knew most of the things that were happening. That's why when he came back, you didn't see any of our executive members at the airport. I was the only person who went to the airport, and I wanted to make sure whether he was going to address the private media. And he didn't.
So and
our worst fears were confirmed.
So in other words, you're saying he was working...
I used the phrase, he hired thugs to disrupt NPF in lieu of his freedom. In exchange of his freedom. Isn't it? I said that at the beginning.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So he's talking about Robert Mugabe. I don't know the role.
President Robert Mugabe.
Former president.
Yeah.
I don't know about the role of Mrs. Grace Mugabe. What role does she have?
She's not a member of NPF. We've told you time and time again that she's not a member. Even President Mugabe is not a member of NPF. But the people go and consult, including Emmerson Mnangagwa wants to meet President Mugabe. He sent envoys. He has sent quite a lot of people to go and consult him. So, as NPF, we have that liberty. She has worked with President Mugabe. I have also worked with President Mugabe. So we are free to go and consult him on any issue. But if we go to consult President Mugabe, as you put it, as a former president, does that mean that we would have gone to see his wife? Why does the issue of his wife come in?
Okay, you are in talks with some alliance partner. What value, since you have said you are a small party?
Not a small party. We never said we are a small party. We are a huge party. We have 80% of Zambia.
I would draw that statement. A new party.
Yes.
A new party. What value are you carrying to the alliance as a new party?
The value was recognized by those that were discussing. If we had no value, they would not have entertained negotiations with us. They would never have approached us to initiate talks on the coalition.
Okay, they approached you.
Yes.
You did not approach them.
Okay. I think we are done, comrade. Thank you very much. Thank you for your patience. I will take left you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, she wants the very
okay.
I'm still listening. Excuse me.